Hey, it's the Travel Jiggler and we are at Kokerboom Kloof campsite in the Richtersveld.
It's about 80 kilometers from Hells Kloof Gate to Kokerboom Kloof, or about 100 kilometers if you're coming from the Sandbox office at Tinlingsrif.
Kokerboom is in the Richtersveld National Park, or rather the Richtersveld IJs Transfrontier Park, which spans between the northwestern part of South Africa into Namibia. These are truly desert conditions. It is arid and dry and extremely hot here in the summertime. This is up in the mountainous part of the Richtersveld National Park, so it is very dry up here. It is a fair distance away from the Orange River, which is the border of the park. Driving here from our previous campsite, which was the Richtersberg campsite on the Orange River, we did not see a single vehicle. So this is a very isolated area. It's pretty much out in the middle of the desert wilderness.
Driving to the campsite may take you as much as 3 hours because there are some sections that are quite steep and the going's quite slow.
The four campsites here are very well spaced. They're probably between 50 and 100 meters apart, so you do get a feeling of isolation and being out here in the wilderness pretty much alone. During the time that we've been here, there's only one other group that is camping and we have never heard them, either in the daytime or in the nighttime. We've seen them once walking past, exploring the area, but other than that, there's only been maybe a couple of vehicles that have come through from other camping areas within the Richtersveld just to check out the area. So, well, basically four vehicles, so two parties that we have seen drive through this area. The ground is fairly uneven, so if you're going to put up a ground tent, then you've got to choose your spot quite carefully. If you're going to put up a rooftop tent, that's a little bit easier, and you can also then of course balance your vehicle and try and get it flat with a couple of rocks or whatever it is. So just be aware of that. In terms of putting down a ground tent, the ground is not very flat and it's difficult to find a spot for a significantly sized tent. There is of course absolutely no grass. It is mostly bare soil with some short shrubs and desert type vegetation. So stuff to do here, obviously you can explore the area, so you can do a couple of walking trails and so on, and you can drive around as well. It is a really beautifully stark area to just visit and enjoy. This is not your normal sort of camping site or national park, whatever the case is. It's extremely arid, so it's very different and it's very appealing in that sense. Keep in mind when you're driving or walking that you must stick to the trails. This is a very fragile ecosystem and there are some very sensitive vegetation and animals in this area. So driving off of the trail is going to damage those. So please stay on the trail. I think as you drive around, you'll find places where people have driven off the trail and created their own tracks. That is not the thing to do. This is a very sensitive ecosystem and you want to stay on those single tracks to maintain its integrity. While we're here, the moon is almost full and it's really bright. Obviously, if we were at new moon, for example, the stars would be fantastic. And we have seen that in other parts of the Northern Cape in the arid areas as well. We haven't experienced that here because the moon, like I said, was at almost full brightness. But if you're going to do some stargazing and you're coming at the right time, it is going to be absolutely fantastic. So this campsite is fairly isolated. It is made up of four individual campsites within the camping area, and that is quite different to the information that we saw on the Sandbox website, which indicates that there are 8 campsites and that those campsites are not serviced other than with dry or long drop toilets. When we got here, we found that there's actually 4 sites, and those sites are actually very well serviced. They've got a little building that includes a flush toilet, a basin with running water as well, and then a shower and a basin which don't have running water but are nevertheless present. There's water here, running water. It appears to be borehole water. We are not sure if this is potable water and there's nothing to indicate that it is or it is not. Being borehole water, it probably is pretty good quality water, especially considering where we are, which is fairly isolated. So you wouldn't expect this water to be polluted, but I cannot guarantee that and there are no signs to confirm that or to confirm the contrary. So make sure you have sufficient water if you're going to come here. It's in the middle of the desert. It is extremely hot. There's absolutely no shelter or shade with the exception of these built structures at the campsites. The campsites, in addition to having ablution facilities, also have built braai pits, or built fire pits rather. So it doesn't have a braai stand, so to speak, or a grill and so on. So you've got to bring your own sort of setup to do your braaiing. However, there is a set of built fire pits on each campsite. There's no electricity here. There is no lighting either, obviously. So there's no solar power, anything of that sort. So insofar as electricity and lighting is concerned, you must bring your own. Having said that, however, in the moonlight, it is pretty bright here because there's quite a bit of reflection off the rocks and the sand and so on that is fairly light in color. So there is a fair amount of natural lighting at night if the moon is up. However, there is no man-made or artificial lighting unless you bring your own. The sites appear to be unserviced. There are no dustbins, so there's nowhere to put your waste. You've got to take all your waste back with you when you leave the park. And this is the case for the other campsites in the Richtersveld as well. So waste-wise, please bring your own black bags or whatever the case is. Keep your rubbish together and make sure that you take it out of the park with you when you're done with camping. You absolutely must be self-sufficient when you come here. There are no shops or services anywhere close by. It is a long drive to get back to the reception gate, or to Senderland's Drift rather, which is the nearest significant town. Alternatively, you can drive back to the nearest campsite, which is the Richtersbach campsite, which is about 32 kilometers away, but that is still a couple of hours drive because it is fairly tough going over a set of passes. It's a one-way track basically. Well, it's a single track basically that is very rocky in places, so very slow going. You must bring your own food. Like I said, there are no shops or services anywhere close by. Basically, whatever you need to eat, drink, braai, cook, whatever the case is, you need to bring that here with you. The last place that you can get fuel or basic supplies is in Senderling's Drift, which is at least 2.5 hour drive from here. Probably a bit more if you're going to stop, etc. along the way here. Just note that the coming here is very slow going. So even though it may seem like it's only a couple of tens of kilometers, it is very slow going because some of the mountain passes are quite steep and convoluted, and you've got to go very slowly over those rocky areas. So how to book? Over the Sandparks website is the easiest way to do it. Of course, you can phone them as well. You can also email reservations at Sandparks. I'll leave a link below to the website where you can do the booking. The website is of course the easiest way to do it. To check into Kookaburra Kloof campsite or any of the other campsites within the Richtersveld, you have got to check in at the main entrance, which is near Senderling's Drift. Other than that, there's no real way to check in. So just note that as well when you're planning your journey here, that you've got to do, or you've got to take the long way around to get into the park. And that is the only place that you can physically check in. When you're checking out, you must check out again at Senderling's Drift at the main reception. So you do need a 4x4 to get here. It doesn't say that on the Sandparks website, and on the way into the Richtersveld Park, it says that you are an SUV or a bucky vehicle with high clearance is recommended, but I would definitely recommend that you have a 4x4 to get here. There are some fairly steep areas that you've got to drive over, and you need clearance, and ideally you need four-wheel drive, and once in a while you will need low range as well. If you're towing a trailer, you're probably going to have an off-road trailer. I think you might have a difficult time getting here with a trailer that's not an off-road trailer. If you've got a caravan, that has got to be an off-road type facility. You are going to have a very difficult time to get here with a normal caravan. The tracks are narrow and some of those gradients are really steep and rocky. Things to be aware of. Firstly, scorpions. We're in the desert, so at night, when the sun goes down and cools down a bit, you will see, or you may see, scorpions running around. So be wary of that. Some of those can be very dangerous, and some in fact can be lethal. So make sure after dark that you are wearing closed shoes. Of course, there are probably snakes around as well, but we haven't seen any, and they will typically tend to be getting out of your way or running away, so it's unlikely that you'll come across them. But obviously enter the bathrooms carefully, just taking those factors into account. What type of camper is this for? Well, I think firstly, you've got to be prepared to be out here and be self-sufficient. I think you've got to be the type of person that likes to be out in the wilderness, away from populated areas, and take note that it's going to take you a significant drive to get back to anywhere where there are significantly populated areas. This is really about being out in the wilderness. So if you're that type of person, then this is the perfect site for you. Who is this not for? I think if you're a novice camper, this is not the place to start. I think you need a bit of experience being out there and being able to be self-sufficient and to sort of know what you need and what to plan and what to pack and what to not pack, etc. So just take that into consideration. I think if you're a beginner camper, so to speak, then you probably want a bit of experience before you come to a campsite like this. So we found the facilities to be in pretty good order. In fact, it's quite impressive. It's a really nice building that they've put up here with, like I said, the basics. You know, there is running water, which is fantastic to have. We weren't expecting that when we got here because the information on the Sandbox website indicates otherwise, but it is actually pretty good. The maintenance appears to be good as well. We haven't found anything that's broken or not working. It's quite clean as well, so it's really pretty good. Of the Ruchtersveld campsites, this is probably not the most family-friendly one because there isn't a lot to do. You can explore the area and go for walks and drives and so on. That's very nice, but it's a lot better, I think, on the riverfront campsites where you can go paddling and swimming and fishing and so on. So that's probably a bit more family-friendly and more friendly for kids and so on. This is still a great place to come and I still do highly recommend it, but maybe less so from a family point of view than the riverfront campsites. Would I recommend Kookaburra Kloof campsite? Yes. We're quite impressed actually with the facilities that are here. We were not expecting them to find them here. And it is really a beautiful place. What sort of camper would I recommend this for? Like I said, you've got to be self-sufficient and you've got to be the type of person that likes to be out in the wilderness away from civilization to a significant extent. And if that's your thing, then yeah, I think this would be a great site for you. I definitely do recommend it. So I hope you found this informative, I hope you liked the episode. If you did, please hit the like button. Also give me some comments below, give us some feedback. If you haven't subscribed, then already subscribe. For those of you that are subscribed and following the channel, thank you very much. Really appreciate all your support. And until the next episode, go everywhere, see everything, have a great time.